Yeah.
What's up, Saxons? It's your counseling team here to bring you all the information that you need in order to pick your classes for next year. This video is going to be quick, hitting five topics, including a quick intro and recap on transcripts, info on forecasting materials, everyone's favorite new classes presentation, the plan for the rest of forecasting week, and a few helpful tips to help you take your schedule to the next level. So let's get cracking. First, let's hit our transcripts. We'll do a much more detailed look into transcripts during tomorrow's advisory, but here are two key pieces of information to get you started. First, your transcripts are now located in the Documents tab on your student view. The file is titled 2021 Forecasting Transcript and is officially your unofficial transcript. Second, the most important piece of information you need for forecasting that comes from your transcript is the information about what credits are still needed for graduation. As you start to plan your classes for next year, which is what we'll be doing for the next 4 days, keep all the classes and credits you still need in mind. That's the important part. At this time, if they haven't already, teachers should be providing digital links to all the forecasting forms you need, including the link to our forecasting website, which has all of this information. If it's easier, just hit pause on the video and scan the QR code real quick. The link to our updated Saxon course registration bulletin, which has the description for every single class we offer at South, as well as important graduation information, and the link to all the available electives for your future grade. And now, the moment you didn't even know you were waiting for, our yearly announcement of new courses. Out of our art department comes five new classes available to any grade level. And after taking a COVID-induced break, we are excited to actually offer calligraphy and origami this year, both of which do not have a prereq and can be taken regardless of your art background. The same is true for mixed media, a course that explores techniques in drawing, painting, collage, and two-dimensional design. Printmaking also doesn't need a prereq and is a class where you get to make artwork in multiples by exploring abstract art subject matter as well as more traditional realistic subjects. And finally, out of our art department, a course modeled after Special Olympics Unified Champion School Opportunities, Unified Art is a class dedicated to promoting inclusion through a shared art experience. This course does not require teacher recommendation. Looking to be an ace on the court? NetSports is the place to serve, spike, dig, and even ping some pong. Out of our PE department comes a great new class centered on pickleball, table tennis, badminton, volleyball, and tennis. And our graphic design department has created further CTE pathways by adding digital arts 2 this year, where students can continue to explore the fundamentals of illustration, typography, color theory, and layout. Must take digital arts 1 to take digital arts 2 though. And finally, out of our sports medicine CTE pathway comes two new courses. The first is health services, and it's a course designed to introduce students to the healthcare field. Intro to health services is recommended before taking this class. And for those who are ready to pursue a career in the area of athletic training, make sure to sign up for Sports Medicine Practicum, where you'll gain actual experience and insight into the athletic training profession by working in our athletic training room. And that, South Salem, is the complete list of your new classes for the 2021-22 school year. Now that you know all the new courses available to you, here's what you need to know for the rest of the week. Tomorrow, we'll be back with a deep dive into transcripts as well as providing the forecasting portal link. You won't want to miss either of these topics. On Thursday, you'll continue working to pick all your classes. Counselors and additional staff will be available on Zoom to answer any questions. Your advisory teachers will provide you the Zoom link. And on Friday, the forecasting portal closes, so you'll want to make sure to get all your classes picked by Friday evening. Counselors and staff will again be available to answer any questions on Friday through Zoom. And finally, here are a few helpful tips as you prepare for forecasting. First and foremost, make sure to use the forecasting resources found on southsaxons.com at the forecasting site. On Wednesday, we'll have a how to forecast video for you to watch. Make sure that you are speaking with your teachers about your core recommendations as well as elective recommendations. This year's forecasting emphasis is on choosing your electives, and so all of the classes you'll be choosing will be elective based. Those core subjects are ones that you want to talk to your teachers in those core areas to talk about those recommendations. Again, this year's forecasting emphasis is on choosing your electives. Make sure you're using those forecasting materials that, again, you can find at southsaxons.com. And finally, as we close out, we wanted to make sure we shared just how pumped we are to get to see you all soon. We're so proud of you, all that you've overcome in this last year, all that you've made it through, and here you are, just weeks away from being together. Great job to all of you. We can't wait to see you soon. We can't wait to be with you, hear your stories, hear about everything you've got going on. So we'll see you soon, and go Saxons!